Hi, good afternoon. My name is Rajesh Babu. Today I am going to give a session about H index, which adds support to secondary indexes for HBase, which are very helpful for faster HBase queries. Before going to session, first let me introduce brief about myself. I am an Apache HBase committer. I am working on HBase from past 2 years. And also I am a senior software engineer at Huawei Technologies India R&D Center. Our team delivers Hadoop distribution for internal using it in internal production and Huawei solutions. In 2003 we have developed secondary indexes on top of HBase, which is called H-index. We have recently open sourced it in the GitHub. Today our agenda is like, first we'll see the brief introduction about HBase, and then we'll go into how H-index works and internal details of the H-index. After that, we will see how to use H-index. At the end, we will see some performance benchmark results, which gives an idea how H-index potentially benefit for product applications. First, let us see a brief introduction about HBase. If we see HBase is a open source distributed NoSQL database, is columnar key value store. It's basically modeled after Google's Bigtable, and it runs on top of HDFS. HBase is very good for random reads and writes of HDFS data. The main goal of the project is to support host larger tables with billions of rows and millions of columns on commodity hardware. Actually, HBase, as I mentioned, HBase is a key value store where the data is stored in key sorted order, lexicographical sorted order. It's basically a sorted map where if we know the key value, we can directly fetch data from the HBase, gives data directly without scanning huge data. And also HBase supports sparse data sets, means each row need not have all the columns data. Wherever the columns not present, simply no cell will be present. No extra storage required for absent of the columns. And actually HBase supports multi-dimensional data. Each value in a cell is not unique, not only identified by the just row key, it's also identified the column family, qualifier, and also timestamp. So different timestamps, with different timestamp, we can have multiple different values, which is like version, we can have multiple versions of each column. And also it is a distributed database, so we can store HBase data in across multiple machines. So also HBase provides automatic failover. If any machine goes down, we can recovery process will happen. And also it runs on top of HDFS. We can leverage many functionalities, features like replication, failure against failures, These features we can get from HDFS. And also, if we see the HBase table, it's horizontally divided into regions. Each region is like contiguous set of row keys. This region is basic unit of scalability and load balancing. When region size, when you do keep on doing writes, then the region size may grows. So once it reaches some threshold, we'll automatically split into two and redistribute. This is, we'll call this as auto sharding. HBase supports auto sharding as well. We'll maintain this meta information about regions, and the key ranges we store in separate table called meta table. And here is the basic overview of basic architecture overview about the HBase. HBase basically have two main processes. One is HMaster and one is HRegion server. HMaster coordinates the cluster and region assignments, and also is responsible for, master is responsible for region assignments, load balancing, and also recovery of failures. The region server basically serves the regions, so reads and writes happen through the region servers. Generally, if you see the in-memory construction of region server, it will have for each column family, we'll have internally one store for each column family. Within the store, we'll have memstore. When this memstore is like in-memory data structure, which holds the writes and reads, first will happen to memstore. When it reaches some threshold, we'll flush into HDFS. It stores stores data in the form of H files. The H file is basically like which will have one or more blocks. So any reads or writes we'll read blocks from that, we'll fetch the records. Similarly, writes also we'll write as a blocks. And also HBase has tight MapReduce integration also. Some cases like if you have some raw data we want to load to HBase, we can use some MapReduce applications. Some cases like snapshots also, we can use MapReduce. There are many tools, MapReduce tools available in HBase. This is a basic introduction about HBase. Since earlier sessions also we have seen the introduction, so need not going into more details. And also HBase provides two basic features, HBase provides one flexible model for extending the HBase functionality without changing the kernel changes. That is called coprocessors. Using these coprocessors, we can run server-supplied code in the client-supplied code in the server side. Actually, there are two kinds of coprocess. One is observers and another one is endpoints. These observers are like triggers. For every operation, some of the operations will have hooks like pre-operation, pre-action, and post-action. This we can see as in the diagram. So whatever we want to, if we want to add some functionality, we can implement these coprocessor hooks, which is provided by the HBase coprocessor framework. So this will be automatically run at the server side. The basic applications of observers are like, if we want to provide a security, we can use the coprocessors without changing any kernel code. Like if we want to write some data, and while writing, you want to check whether the user who is writing is authenticated or not. So such kind of things we can use observers. And endpoints are like It's a dynamic RPC interface for dynamic RPC extension. The endpoint implementation will run on one or multiple regions parallelly. We can run anytime from the client. And at the same time, these implementations will give some results back to the client. The basic examples for these endpoints are like, we can, if we want to perform some aggregation kind of things, we can use the aggregation operations like minimum, max, maximum of maximum, and the average of values. We can use these endpoints. One more feature which is providing HBase providing is filters. These filters are like, these are like predicates in the normal RDBMSs, like where condition clauses, we have some conditions. Similar way, we can, the conditions we can provide in the HBase using the filters. These filters help to limit the output of the scan. If we want, let us suppose if we want to find the some records matching only matching some conditions, so we may get very less records. So we need not fetch all the records to client side. So which helps to avoid network overhead. These are the basic features. The mainly in second indexing implementation, we are using coprocessors and filters. Now we can see the problem statement. Actually, now if we want to search, let us suppose we have a table, employee table like this. We have some columns like name, mobile number, salary, and department like this. If you, and also we have the row key, which is actually, now if we want to search employee name by row key value, HBase supports random reads and writes. So, and also the row key is in sorted order. We can directly fetch the records with the row key. Which is very good for point queries. So from this table, we can directly, if we know the key value, we can directly get the information required for that. What if we want to search for by column value? Let us suppose if we want to find the user name of the user whose mobile number is 123. Here the mobile is the column in the person table. Then actually what we need to do is we need to fetch record by record, and we need to go through full table, we need to do full table scan. When we have billions of rows, which will take lot of time to go through full table scans. And also sometimes because of this, we are not getting response from the server side, client will get timeouts, and sometimes we'll get lease expiries. So to avoid these problems, what we have decided is we wanted to add secondary index support to the HBase, and we have done that using coprocessors. Now we can see how introduction about HIndex and how HIndex will work using how secondary HIndex works. We will see internal details also. This is a basic introduction about HIndex. It's coprocessor based implementation, which is 100% server side. There will be no data transfer to client side and any no network calls involved in this. And when you maintain indexes, what we'll do is all the index data we'll maintain in separate table. If we have multiple indexes also, we'll store all the indexes data in separate only one table. Only one index table. And this is we'll call is region wise, it is like For each region data, we'll maintain each region data in separate index region. This is we'll call region wise indexing, also called local indexing. Means if you have whatever the if you have user data in the one user data of one region, we will store in separate index region. There will be not there is not like this one region data will be stored in multiple regions. Since we have one to one mapping, we can collocate both user region and index region. So which will help in many cases, which will help to which will help like which will give good performance, write performance, and also scan case. We can without any network overhead, we can use secondary indexes. For that, we have for collocating user regions and index region, we have implemented one custom balancer. We will go through that internally in detail. We can go through that. Basically, index table row key will be in this form: region start key, index name, and all the indexed column values will append together. And at the end, we'll store user table row key. We'll see why we are added these details in the further slides. This is the basic architecture of HIndex. This whatever is in the green color, it is basic HBase, whatever HBase already supporting, and orange color we have added as part of HIndex. Basically, what we have is this indexing coprocessors. It's basically is like some coprocessor hooks implementations provided in the master side, and some coprocessor implementation provided at the region server wise and region level. Coprocessor hooks, we'll combine it together, we are calling as an index coprocessor. This indexing coprocessor will, whatever the operations we want to perform on index table, we'll use this indexing coprocessor. But main implementation, actually what we'll do is, we'll not do any extra things, just if some operation like if you are doing create table, internally, whatever HBase is doing for creation, that only we'll use. We'll reuse the code. We'll not re-implemented that. And also, already HBase provides a load balancer for balancing regions across the multiple region servers. So we are extending this existing load balancer to support collocation. And to specify the index details, we need some changes in the kernel side. We need some changes in the client side, so that we are calling as client extension. This is just for specifying the index details only. Here we can see the user table data and the index table data. Any operations on index table go through indexing coprocessors only. This is the basic architecture about HIndex. Now, with secondary indexes, how searching for a column value will gives how it will give the performance, how it will help, how it will give good performance, that we can see how secondary indexing work. Also, we will see that. Let us suppose if we want, now we are searching for a column value. So our query of we have interest in the mobile column, so we can create sub index for the mobile column. Let us suppose if we create mobile index on mobile column, the index data will be, in general it will be like this. It's like a index table is a reverse table where key part column value become the key part and the row key of the table become the value. But we are not storing like this. We are storing in this way. Means we are appending user table row key at the end of the, for index table row key, we are appending user table row key at the end. Why? Because if we have one column, one value is available in multiple rows, we can ensure that row key also comes in sorted order. For such purposes, we are appending row key also, user table row key to the index row key. Now, if you want to search by column value, since this column value is if we know the column value from the column value, we can directly find user table row key. So here, if we see, as we know, 1, 2, 3 column value 1, 2, 3. So we can directly go to the location where 1, 2, 3 index table index row key starts with 1, 2, 3. From that, we can direct find the user table row key, which is 141. What we'll do is from this row key, we can go back to the user table and find the required information from the index table. This is how with index we can search column values. And as I told, index will be maintained per region. Let us suppose here 123 to 142 is one region. So whatever the data in the this region will be stored in separate region. Since both user region and index region are collocated, if you want to perform any writes to index table, and also if you want to scan from the index and go back to the user table, we need not make any network calls, which will be very good for performance. And even if we collocate both user region and index region, some cases we need to be handled. Some are like region movement and also region splits. Region movement is like some user region is moved to another region server, how we move index region also to that region server. We can do, if a balancer is doing region movement, we will do automatically, this balancer will take care of moving the index region as well. Or if some cases, if we are moving only user region through coprocess, we will move index region also to the same region server. Like that, we will handle the collocation at any point of time. And also, what if region is divided, one user region is divided into two? Then what we need to do is we need to divide the index region also into two, and still we need to maintain the collocation of the two data regions, two user data regions and index data regions. That also we are handling, that we can go through in the further slides. This is basic how the collocation looks like. Let us suppose we have a table with a key ranges A to B is one region, B to C is one region. Internally, through coprocess, we will create index region also with the same key value, key ranges. And whatever the key now A to B is one region, B to C is another region. If we assign A to B to region server 1, the index region of the key range A to B also will be assigned to the same region server. Like this collocation will happen. Now we can see how put operation will be handled on index table. Let us suppose we have a table T1 with the column family CF, and we have created index on two columns, CF Q1 and CF Q2. And when you create indexes internally, index table is not present, we'll create index table. If we are specifying index details at that time of user table creation only, we'll internally through coprocess we'll create the index table as well. And now if we do puts on the columns which are indexed, then what we'll do is internally through coprocess we'll write to the index table, index region as well. Since both regions reside at the same region server, there will not be any network calls. The put performance also very good. And also, since all index data we are maintaining in the same single table, and the collocation also will be very easy. Now, if we just for an example, if we are doing put put on the table where row key is AAB and this first column CFQ1 value is 5, CFQ2 Z1, then actual index table puts will be will form in the coprocessors and will write to the index index region. Actually, and also along with performance, we are handling this through atomic. We are handling it atomically. It means the both puts will happen to both user region and index region, or never happen. For this, we are internally having some write ahead log observer implementation also. We are using that one. Now we can see the scan operation. When you perform a scan on scan with the condition where the condition involves indexed columns, then what we'll do is, when you first first we'll create the scanner for the user region, and internally through coprocessor we'll create the scanner scanner for index region as well. Before that, what we'll do, we have one filter evaluator which will automatically identify the best fit indexes for the condition. If any index is available, we'll create the scanner on the index table and we'll keep aside. When you try to fetch your records using next call, then we'll use the index scanner. Here we can see how we can fetch the records. Now, after creating scanners, now let us suppose if client requested the next, then what we'll do is, first we'll go to index region through coprocessors and find the matching row key. Find the matching row key in the index table, and from that row key we can seek exact row key, seek to exact row in the user region. What is the advantage of this seek is, here we can see the internal more detail about scan, how scan works. And mainly, like if you seek from one position to another position, sometimes what will happen, we can skip some full H files, or within the H file we can skip some H file blocks as well. This helps to avoid disk IO. And like the sometimes what will happen is, we can skip full H files or some multiple H files also. So, and also, since both regions reside at the same region server, there is nothing to send records to client side and also get some information from the clients. Nothing like that will happen. This way we can get the better performance with secondary indexes. This is about the scan. Now, just for sake of easiness, we are using this RDBMS queries, but internally they will be filters only. Even if it is range, we can have filters for range conditions, also some filters for equal conditions. And if you want to combine multiple, if you have multiple conditions with AND or queries also, we can have the filters. We can see that, we can see here, now we can see how we can, sometimes what will happen is, see, with single index only, we may not fetch all the records. Single index we may not fetch, so we can merge indexes to find the matching rows, and from that we can fetch actual data. Here we can see some queries with AND condition. Let us suppose if we want to select the name of the person with whose department is OH and title is TL. Here we have two columns in our query. So basically, if we want, we can create index and department or title, or we can have both indexes for both columns also. If we have only one index, then we can go through one index and whatever the rows row keys whatever the row keys available in that index, from that we can get the data. Let us suppose we have created two indexes. The indexes data will be we'll think as it will be like this in two indexes, index one, index two. But actually we are storing all index data in single table, which is single table only. This will be good for this makes the collocation easier, and also we are prefixing with index name. Why? Because if we prefix with index name, all index data we can store together. This is how actual data will be stored in the index table. When you have multiple conditions, here what we'll do is first, based on this condition, we'll identify the best fit indexes, and also for the index scanners, we'll identify the key ranges. So within these key ranges only, the data will reside within these key ranges. That we'll do through filter evaluator. So here basically when you have equal queries on department and title, then the key ranges will be like this: start keys and end keys for the both index scanners will be like this. So basically first what we'll do is, when you do index merges with AND, it's like we need to fetch intersection of the row keys from the both indexes. For that, what we'll do is first from both indexes, we'll find the maximum row key, and from other indexes, we can jump to the maximum row key. It is like whatever the row keys before this maximum, anyway will not be present in the matching row keys. Let us suppose here we have 123 and 142 as a matching row keys. First index, we have 142 is maximum, so we can jump the first index to 142. So like this, we are skipping some more records to scan with the help of other indexes data, other indexes matching row keys. And since here both the row keys are matching, we can find that we can go back to the user table and find the records, find the information required from the user table. Similarly, we'll fetch the row keys and find the maximum and jump the other scanners to the maximum value. This way, index merge will give a better performance because we are skipping many row keys within the index data. This is how it will happen now. And one more thing is, like, if one scanner has reached the end, then we need not scan other other indexes also, so we can close both the scanners. This is how index merge with AND conditions. It's like index intersection. Now we can see how multi-column indexes helps to fetch merge the multi-column indexes when our query has involves multiple column conditions. Similarly, now we can take the same query where the department is OH and title is TL. Similarly, based on these conditions, we'll form again key ranges. Within the key ranges, whatever the row keys we present, we will fetch the data from that. Here the ROCEs within this ranges are 142 is the one. So we can directly go to user table and get the information. Similarly, 142 also is a matching record. So we can have the like this, we can have multi-column indexes also. Now we can see, let us suppose if we want to, if we have conditions, R conditions, which are connecting to equal, which are connecting to equal conditions of the different columns, then here when we have equal conditions, the row keys here will be in sorted order. So while returning to the client also, we can give the data in sorted order only. We need not maintain any intermediate data structure for sorting these details. If we have equal queries, the row keys anyway will be in the sorted order. So if we want to perform union, what we will do is first we will fetch row keys from the both indexes and find the minimum of the minimum, and we will continue scanning that index part only until we reach the second exceeds the second minimum. So here we can see 123 is the minimum, so we can keep on scanning first index. So we get 142, which is less than 141, less than 142. So still scanning, we'll get 142. So here we got 152, which is more than 142. So we can switch the scanners. And now we keep on scanning the second index. So like this, we can get the data in sorted order only, without any intermediate information. And generally, if we do union, we need to ensure there should not be any duplicate records will come in the come at client side. So that also we are handling. This is how basically conditions with R will work. Apart from this, here, when we have equal conditions, since row keys will be in sorted order, so without any intermediate storage, we can give, we can send the records in sorted order. But if sometimes if we are fetching range of, if we are having range queries, what we need to do is the row keys will not be in sorted order. So for that, we are maintaining some intermediate storage to avoid the duplicates. At present, we are not ensuring the sorted from the server side. Now we can see the region splits. The region splits are like basically like when you have user table region. Here we can see region table with 0 to 9 and similarly indexed region. If we want to split at the 0-5, what will happen is we'll divide this into two data regions. Data between 0 to 4 will go to one data region, 5 to 7 will go to another region. When we split the index region, what we need to do is we'll basically look at the user table row key, which is appended at the last. Based on that, we'll identify whether it belongs to first data region or second data region. So when we're splitting the H files physically, based on the row key, if it is less than the split point, we'll write to one first data region. If it is more than the split point, we'll rewrite to the second data region. And one more thing is, while rewriting the second data region, we'll replace the start key with user region start key, which is here. Earlier it is 0-1, but after splitting, it will be the second region start key will be 0-5, so we are replacing with that. This is how region split work. Now we can see the usage. If you want to use 94 version, if you want to try with 94 version, you can see the link here. We have put it in GitHub. You can go through the installation steps and configurations also. Now also we have given the patch for trunk version, the issue the we have Jira for that. Here we have the patch which is working with 94R trunk. If you want to try, you can try the patch. And also these are the configurations as per the 90 the patch available at trunk version. Here are the configurations we need to configure at the server side, and we need to sometimes we need to restart. Here basically like whatever the coprocessor implementation done, coprocessor hooks implemented at master and region servers, and also some coprocessor implementation implementations of wall also, these are the classes we need to configure. And the custom balancer, we have the custom balance, that also we need to configure and restart the master. And since everything we are handling at the server side, we need not change much in the client side. Only thing is like we need to specify the index details. It is like here for this index specification is the way we are specifying the index details, and we'll add the columns whatever we need to index to the index specification. At the end, what we'll do is we'll send this index information. We are adding to table this index information as a metadata to the table descriptor. So that is how we can specify the index details. And while creating table, actually for this second index, we have created one client side changes we need to do, like when you create user table, index table also should be created. Until that, we should wait. For that purpose, we are using one special admin, like index admin. So we need to create tables with that admin. Even any admin operations, we need to use index admin. These are the some set of tools we have provided. If you have user data and if you want to create indexes, you can use the table indexer on MapReduce job. And also, if you want to load both user data and index data together, we can use index import TSV tool. And also, index load incremental H files. Like it will load both store files of user table and the index table together at the same time. And also, if there are any, because of the cluster is not healthy, and in some cases, if there are any mismatches, we can use a second index collocator. And now we can see the test results. Here we have done the performance benchmarks with index and without indexes. For that, we have five region servers cluster. We have cluster with five region server, and we have created table with 100 regions. Basically, when we do put performance, we have done with 100 GB data, which has around 1 million records. Here, we have done performance without index, with single column index, multi-column index, and also we have done multiple indexes also. If we see, even with the five multiple indexes, the put performance not degraded to double also. Since this is because we are collocating both user region and index regions. And if you see the scan performance, we have done the scan performance with 50 GB data. The cluster is the same, and table as the same. Each record size is 500 bytes. Now, if we see the performance with if we want to search for a column value which is indexed, here we have. We are searching for find x, which is we have around 9600 matching records. So to fetch this without index, it is 580 seconds, with index 55 seconds, which is like 10 times performance improvement is there. Even if we have sometimes if a value is available in huge number of records, then also we are getting the better performance. Here we have done the same test with where the value present in multiple rows, like 170,000 rows. Still we are getting five times performance. Let us suppose we can merge both the indexes and find the matching row keys. with the same where value is find x and this second column value find y. Still with the index merge we are getting as equal to the this first results. It's like even with less records, how much performance we are getting. Similar way we are getting with index merge also. Now if we want here is the benchmark for range queries. We are searching for values within the range of 1 to 1 lakh. We are having 80,500 records around. Then still we are getting 10 times improvement in the range queries also. We have done performance with multi column indexes, which is here also we are getting 10 times performance. Similar, this is about the performance results, and this is summary. Apart from this range and equal queries, we are supporting part of indexing and part of column value, and also we can add dynamically drop the columns indexes. We have provided some hints, like sometimes we can skip the indexes using the indexes. So we have intelligent filter evaluator for identifying best fit indexes. The application side, only the during creation or specifying indexes only we need some changes. Otherwise, even puts when read and write path, we need not have any changes. So we can use any clients like Phoenix or Thrift or anything REST also. And this is about summary, and this is about roadmap. If you come into roadmap, actually we want to contribute this to HBase, and the work is in progress. And also we want to integrate this with Apache Phoenix. And apart from this, we want to make some improvements in the filter evaluator, which can evaluate any kind of expressions, like it may be expression from the Phoenix or anything. It can identify the best fit indexes. And also we want to have HBase secret tool for supporting for maintaining ensuring consistency in the admin operations or region assignments. We want to make an HBase secret tool for that. This is about the roadmap. That's it from the H index. Any questions and answers?
So when a region splits,
yeah,
do you need to make a full pass through the index data to kind of rejigger things so that the index data is still co-located with the data region that split?
Actually, the region split, when you split the region, we'll initially what we'll have is we'll maintain reference files. When we're rewriting the during compaction, we'll replace the second data region start key with the.
Oh, I see. Start. So you delay the. Huh? You delay splitting the
anyway,
index.
Anyway, the split itself will be happen like that. During compaction only, they will be rewrite.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. I think we are almost out of time. So just one more question.
I don't know enough about the actual internals there, but have you considered implementing the indices using separate stores in the same region instead of as an actual region that you now need to collocate and you need to like deal with the load balancer and all that stuff?
Can you repeat?
So instead of adding indices as a separate region that you now need to maintain with the load balancer, you need to, like, the master needs to know about it, it needs to be collocated on the same region server, etc. Have you thought about what was the reason not to implement this, for example, using a separate store that sits on the side in the same region? So it's
yeah, actually we have thought that improvement as we can maintain in separate column this index data in the same separate column in the same table. But yeah, that helps to avoid this all admin operations on index table. That we have thought, and we have raised some improvement action also. We have in the plan. Yeah, we can do that also. But we need to make some changes in the client side for that. Yeah, there is some improvement like, that I will tell you. Actually, I'll take help of Ted you and I'll explain about.
Okay. Let's thank Rajesh for his nice presentation. Thank you.